Hello, I'm David Frost. When President Nixon resigned in disgrace in 1974, some of the most damning evidence against him was evidence that he had collected himself in recordings that he made in the Oval Office. Of those hundreds of hours of intimate recordings, perhaps the most compelling and intriguing are the missing ones, the 18.5-minute gap that was created when his secretary, Rosemary Woods, accidentally erased the tapes. What was in that 18.5-minute gap? Well, that has plagued historians and citizens alike since that time nearly 40 years ago. But today, we have at least a segment that has been restored from that 18.5-minute gap, and it gives us a chilling portrait of what went on inside the Oval Office.
White House recording dated June 20th, 1972. Richard Nixon and Henry Kissinger.
Henry.
Yes, Mr. President.
Is this the real life?
I'm sorry, I don't think I understand.
Is this the real life? Or is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, Henry. There's no escape from reality.
Well, open your eyes, Mr. President. Look up to the skies and see...
I'm just a poor boy. I need no sympathy. Because it's easy come, easy go. A little high, a little low. Any way the wind blows, doesn't really matter to me. Not to me.
But perhaps Nixon's most shocking confession follows here.
Mama just killed a man. I put a gun upside his head.
President, what do you say?
Pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun.
Mr. President.
Now I've gone. I've thrown it all away.
Mr. President, calm yourself.
Mama! Oh! I didn't mean to make you cry. If I'm not back this time again tomorrow, carry on.
I will, Mr. President.
Carry on! Carry on.
We will, Mr. President. Nothing really matters. Mr. President, I see a little silhouette of a man.
Jesus Christ, how did he get in here?
At this point in the recording, Kissinger has noticed an observer in the room, a little silhouette of a man, as he refers to it, and tells Nixon to scaramouche, scaramouche, to cease the conversation, which Nixon does. Who is this little silhouette of a man? Was it a member of the White House staff, or was it a Secret Service agent? We may never know. One thing we do know is that, after that point, anyway, the wind blows really did matter to Richard M. Nixon, and shortly after he resigned and entered a world of rhapsodic, some would say bohemian, seclusion. The shooting incident involving Nixon's mother was never fully explained. I'm David Frost.